The shark, babe, has such teeth, dear, and it shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has old Maggie, babe, and it keeps it.
The Student Union Building itself was home away from home. And you have food, you have restrooms, you have games, you have movies, you have, you know, just about anything you can think of.
Oftentimes there were activities, whether it was a dance or a concert. We had some really top name entertainers come here and play for our dances. Never a trace of red.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships roll in.
The Bengal Lair, which no longer exists, but was the closest thing we had to a pub. And of course, that was, you had to fight in line to get into that place. Watching the tide
roll away. In the 60s, I played a lot. I majored in pinochle and minored in bowling. I mean, you could come up here any time of the day and catch a pinochle game. You go back in the Bengal Lair back there and play pinochle for hours. Sorry, Mom. So I played a lot, so the Student Union was very important to me then.
Anytime you have a big new structure with expanded facilities and you know, there's just a kind of an aura that is exciting.
The neat thing about it was the Union always was full of people into the evening. And if you scheduled something for the Hypostyle, you knew you'd have a crowd because it gravitated from one to the other because it's open.
And we used to have dances every Saturday, Friday night, every Friday night in the ballroom, or Saturday night, I can't remember, but it was on the weekend. And so they had four of us walking around at all times. They called us smoke jumpers because we'd walk around and try to catch people smoking and then tell them they couldn't smoke in the ballroom.
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
When John F. Kennedy was shot, I remember coming immediately to that lower level where the televisions were so that I could find out what was really going on. And all of the hundreds of students that were gathering, watching that and somehow sharing together that terrible loss. And I always, when I think of the John F. Kennedy assassination, I think of being in the Student Union watching television to get that news.
Every student, I can say this without hesitation, every student who spent time here at Idaho State spent time in the Union. If they spent time in the Union, they knew Earl, or they knew of Earl. And I think walking in for the 50th anniversary, there's going to be a little bit of that nostalgia twang that hits you. And you're going to think, yes, I know this building. I was here, and this was my comfort zone. And immediately everyone is going to say, yeah, I knew Earl. I was privileged. I knew Earl Pond.
People writing songs that voices never share.